Yeah. So we go to question 5. Shows various regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. Yeah. What is the name of component N? Instead of just naming N, we are just going to name all the components. These are radio waves, and then these are microwaves, infrared rays, visible light, ultraviolet as indicated, and then we've got X-rays and gamma rays. So what is the name of component N? Component N are X-ray. It's an X-ray. And then give one practical use of region M. What is region M? Region M is what we're just from naming as the infrared rays. And infrared rays have got quite some uses. But the common uses, I'll just mention the common uses. They are used in heat sensitive thermal imaging cameras, something like that. Yeah. And then which can be used to study human and animal body heat patterns. But they're also used in night vision cameras. Those cameras used to view in the night. And most remote controls, like, yeah, the common ones, DSTV, the remotes for electronic devices, they also use infrared rays. Yeah. So those are the some of the uses. But you can just say the in heat sensitive thermal imaging cameras or night vision cameras. Those are one of the practical uses. State one property which is the same for all electromagnetic waves. First of all electromagnetic waves have got the same speed, which is the speed of light, 3.0 times 10 to the power 8 meters per second, or 300 million meters per second. And then state one possible source. Oh, first of all, on this C, you can even mention the wave function, the wave equation. They've got the same wave equation. Yeah, they are supported by the same wave equation, which is velocity is equal to frequency times the wavelength. State one possible source of the radiation from region O. The region O is the gamma. So, on Earth, gamma waves are generated by nuclear explosions, and then lightning and the less dramatic activity of radioactive decay, which is radioactivity. Yeah, it's one of the sources of gamma ray. Yeah, so we are now on question 7. Shows a magnetic field lines between the poles of two magnets. Name point R. So repulsion is taking place here. And point R is a region where the resultant field intensity is zero. This is the neutral point. It is called the neutral point. So we go to B. So the name point R, that's the neutral point. If P is a south pole, what are the poles Q and T? So if this is the south pole, what are the poles Q and T? Repulsion is taking place, and then this is the south pole, meaning this is the north pole. And if this is a repulsion thing, then this is also the north pole. So Q is the north pole, and then T, this is the north and this is the north. T is also a south pole, just like P. Explain how... Yeah, so soft iron keepers help magnets retain their magnetism for a longer period because they preserve the strength of the magnet by completing their magnetic circuit. And they are more important to those magnets with low coercivities. Yeah, so the explanation is just by preserving the strength of the magnet, by completing the magnetic circuit so that the field lines are not disturbed. State two differences between iron and steel as magnetic materials. One difference is that iron takes a short time to be magnetized, while steel takes a long time to be magnetized. And then steel retains its magnetism for a long time, while iron is demagnetized after a very short period of time. Question 8. Question 8 shows three resistors connected to a 12 volts battery. The effective resistance between X and Y. So there was an error here. They didn't label X and Y, but we are going to label X here and Y here. So we are going to find the effective resistance here. So let's just work that out. So what we want to find is the effective resistance here between these parallel resistors. Between X, we are going to put X here and Y here. So 1 over the R effective resistance is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. 1 over R effective will be equal to 1 over R1 will be 12 plus 1 over 6. And this will be equal to 1 over 12 plus 1 over 6. That's 1 over 4. So we are going to cross multiply, and it will give us the effective resistance is equal to 4 ohms. So that's the effective resistance. So calculate the current flowing in through the 6-ohm resistor. Oh, sorry, not this one. The current flowing in the battery. So the overall current. So So this was circuit is equivalent to this one if we find the effective resistance. So this effective resistance four, and now they are in series. So we just had to add them to find the total resistance, which is equal to 6 ohms. So what is the current? This is 12 volts. Current is equal to V over R, which is equal to voltage 12 over the resistance 6, which is equal to 2 amps. And then the next question is asking us to find the current flowing through the 6 ohms resistor. So we are going to use this same circuit to find the voltage drop in this 4 ohm resistor. So the voltage drop will be V is equal to IR. So the voltage in this 4 ohms effective resistance will be equal to 2 times the error, which is, times the error here, which is 4. So 2 amps times the 4 ohms will be 8 volts. But we just want to find, so we go back to the same circuit again, the first one. We just want to find the current in this 6 ohm resistor. The current in this 6 ohm resistor. So it will be different. Now, we are going to find, since the voltage is the same, it's 8 volts, since they are in parallel, the voltage will be the same. But what about the current? So the current, so the current will be equal to voltage over R. The voltage will be 8 volts over R, which is 6 ohms. And the answer will be 8 over 6, that's 1.33 amps. Yeah, so we go to B9. Polonium can undergo radioactive decay by emitting an alpha particle to form lead. What is an alpha particle? An alpha particle is a radioactive particle that is released, and it is helium in nature with a very strong ionizing effect. Write the equation for the radioactive decay of polonium. So we are going to write the radioactive decay equation. So if polonium decays, it's 210 and 84. It will decay into lead, which is Pb. But for us to find the atomic number and the mass number of Pb, first we have to omit the alpha particle, which is 4. This is the alpha particle, which is helium in nature. And then if we subtract 4 from 210, it will give us 206. And then from here we subtract 2, it will be 82. So this will be the radioactive decay of polonium. State 1 is of alpha radiation. Alpha radiation can be used to treat all forms of cancer in hospitals. It's one use of alpha radiation. So you go to section C.